Vimby and Mrs. Vimby.
Yes, well, hello. Thank you, President. Nice to see you.
This is my wife.
Hello there. Nice to see you.
My vice president.
How do you do?
I'm the Secretary for Foreign Affairs, Dito Chidonji.
Hello there. Hello, Security Advisor. And Mrs. Vimby.
Mrs. Vimby, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Mr. Vice President.
President.
Senator.
Well, let us come in and out. Chair over there. Well, it's good to have you back visiting here again.
Mr. President, thank you very much for receiving me.
Well, this is my first opportunity to congratulate you personally for your stunning victory in the battle from Vimby.
Thank you very much, Mr. President.
At the time, I referred to you as the hero of the Lombok River.
Yes, Mr. President. And now, thanks to the support of the U.S., now we are stronger.
Well,
thank you,
that's
Mr.
good.
President.
Well, I must say, in your public statements here, you have been very, well, you've taken a statesmanlike position, which we appreciate very much.
Thank you, Mr. President. Thank you.
I've often made the point that you don't seek to overthrow the Angola government, but are calling for a democratic system.
Yes, Mr.
President. Could everybody turn slightly sideways so you can crunch the closer? That's good. You move.
Yes.
There on the
side. We're sideways facing each other from this side.
Yes,
well,
yeah. Mr. President, move up to the right. Thank you.
Facilities for tritium. They've got the chemical separations facilities. They've got the operation support laboratory. All that. They've saved hundreds of millions of dollars to put it there instead of taking it somewhere else. Now, the personnel, they are all trained. They've got 18,000 people working in Georgia and South Carolina. And they won't have to spend time. Now, if that should be moved somewhere else, a lot of those people wouldn't even go. And then you'd have to train new people all over again. That'll cost a lot of money to do that. Now, the Savannah River plant also has the only defense waste processing facility to classify high-level nuclear waste. In other words, they put this waste in glass. And it's the only facility in the United States. And that's got to be...
Mr. President Stacy Eggenberger.
Hello there. Yeah. Nice to see you.
Great. This is Jessica Eggenberger.
Hello there. Nice to see you.
Okay, Bobby.
And Bobby.
Bobby, it's good to have you here.
And their mother, Kathleen.
Hello there. Well, nice to see you.
Nicole Rubello.
Hello. Nice to see you.
John Rubello.
Hello. Nice to see you.
Omar Rubello.
Hello.
My honor to meet you. Yeah. Thank you.
Okay.
Wait a
minute. Jessica? Excuse me, Jennifer.
Jessica?
Jerry Lee? Chisholm?
Hello there. Hi. Nice to have you.
Thank you.
And this is Frederick Thompson.
Frederick, good to see you.
His father, Fred Thompson.
Wonderful, Mr. Fred. Nice to see you.
Susan Aiken.
Hi, how are you doing?
Hello. You sure have. It's wonderful what you're doing.
Phil Hazeltine.
Mr. President.
Congressman Jim Zaxton.
Mr. President. How are you?
Nice to see you. Yeah. Good to see you.
Thank you.
And Jim Johnson.
Mr. President. Hello. Great place to be with you. Thank you for seeing us.
Everybody, I know that the love, you want to keep care of all of you parents, and enforcing seatbelt laws, rules of the law, laws, probably saved the lives of these young people that are here. And we've got to keep going on signing the resolution here when the press photographer is going to come in, but. There are 32 states already that have seatbelt laws, 50. And last year alone, the figure is 2,450 people. Lives were saved by seatbelts in accidents that took place. So I'll get down here and a bunch of photographers will come in.
Just a second.
Yes, before he signs.
Smile on it. Look at that.
I'm signing a resolution that has to do with safety. You are photographing a number of young people here who are here because they wore seatbelts. It is done. Oops, that was you can. All right.
On behalf of all these young people, we have a little presentation. Ever since you were governor of California, you've been very supportive of seatbelt use. And these children are living proof of the fruits of that effort. And on their behalf, I'd like to present you with something you badly need, a hat. And something you can use when you're out there chopping wood out in California. And I understand that that's a favorite color of yours. And it says America clicks, and that's for the seatbelt. And you put that belt on, and I know you wear it, and I know they wear it.
Thank you very much. I don't know whether I'll do this all up top.
Riding your horse.
Riding my horse.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Governor Wilson. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. President.
I saw her first when she was Miss America.
I thought I got to come back because I barely remember that. It was so nice. Bye-bye. Thank you so much.
Thank you for having us. Thank you very much.
Case of using them, I would like to see us do our best to get them in a drug treatment organization and that they agree to accepting a cure.
So the policy is going to be give them a second chance?
I have always said that I think that this is another indication of why compulsory drug testing is not bad. It is one of the principal answers, but let the people know that we'll do our best to salvage anyone who's been addicted.
Isn't it true, Mr. President, that it wasn't drug testing that caught these people, it was actually a tip?
I'm not commenting on the investigation, but it certainly wasn't drug testing, no, because we didn't have them.
Well, wouldn't that mean that we should encourage whistleblowers instead of drug testing?
No, I think drug testing is the best way.
Are you affronted that it took place in the White House?
What's that?
Are you upset that it's here in the White House?
Well, yes, of course, I'm upset when it's found anywhere. Incidentally, I passed my test.
Cameras this way, please. This way. Was Mrs. Reagan upset? Mrs. Reagan upset about this? Have you discussed it?
Of course you're upset about something of this kind. Any of
it. But you and your wife were never in any personal danger in the nature of their duties.
No, I didn't think so.
Thank you.
Thank you all.
Thank you, Mrs. Gray. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank all of you for taking time out of what I know is a very busy schedule to come down here on this important issue. As the campaign season heats up, it's becoming more and more important. It's apparent that a key issue will be how to deal with the country's drug problem. I think our administration has done a lot, and we mustn't let anyone steal this as a campaign issue from us. Since I took office in 1981, creating a drug-free America has been a high priority of this administration. Some of the administration's goals were accomplished, such as heightening awareness of the dangers of illegal drug use, promoting cooperation on this issue among public and private sector efforts, and yesterday was kind of interesting, just flying out of Miami to come back here after appearing at that fundraiser for Connie Mack. Our plane taxiing went by quite a collection of airplanes of various styles and types and so forth. They are all airplanes that have been seized. Those were transporting drugs. I don't know just what we're going to wind up doing with them. May 18th, I announced a formation of a legislative executive task force, and urging that deliberations begin within the next week. I mean, I urged that at that time. And this afternoon, Attorney General Meese and Dr. Ian McDonald are presenting me with some strategy proposals to the National Drug Policy Board. And just the other day, I received a voluminous report from a team headed by Lois Harrington that has gone all over this country and has come back with hundreds of suggestions as to what we must do. I wanted to get you here today to hear your ideas and proposals. And Guy, why don't you start off and tell me what you're hearing from your